The Keysight IoT0047A regulatory test solution provides a flexible and efficient way to accelerate certification of unlicensed wireless devices. Before, during, and after full compliance testing, the IoT0047A offers multiple ways to cover more tests for more standards in less time. Wireless standards continue to evolve, and wireless devices will need to be tested for regulatory compliance against the standards. Together with the IoT0047A, the XA5001A test software covers ETSI EN300328 and EN301893 standards. As you can see, the XA5001A software takes you through the steps needed to run the test. You must first define and set up the respective instruments, making sure they are connected. Next, you will set up parameters for the device under test or DUT, such as antenna gain, device type, modulation, path loss, and more. Once the DUT is set up, the software lets you set up the test parameters and then choose from a list of tests under the ETSI standard. In this video, we will take a look at the adaptivity test for channel access mechanism, which is an automatic mechanism by which a device limits its transmissions and gains access to an operating channel. Shown on the screen is where you can set the sampling rate, monitor time, channel occupancy time, and the attenuation used inside the instruments. The transmission portion of the setup is to determine how much of the time the channel will be busy or on the air. You also need to set the interference that you will inject into the test, such as additive white Gaussian noise, long-term evolution or LTE signal, or orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, which are all specified by ETSI. In the test procedure section, you can select the part of the test that you wish to run, in cases where you're not interested in running the entire suite of tests. This is convenient, especially for engineers looking to diagnose a failure. The next step is to run the test. By clicking on the button, the test will start and the software will prompt you to ensure that the connection of the instruments is done correctly. Clicking OK will trigger the test to start. The log files and status of the test are shown at the bottom of the screen. Next, the results. Shown here are the idle period chart and its numerical breakdown of the results. You will also have the tabular breakdown of the channel occupancy time and a channel occupancy time chart. Lastly, the results can be exported into 6 different report formats. This is a quick look into the XA5001A test software for adaptivity, channel access mechanism, and the measurements that can be made to meet the ETSI 301893 requirements.